The world population is becoming increasingly mobile. People are traveling more and more. The airline industry is experiencing unprecedented growth, and there's some 4 billion plus global travelers every year getting on planes. That's created a whole new set of challenges for the healthcare industry and related organizations to try to figure out where and when the next outbreak of disease is going to be, and how do you prevent that, predict it, and contain it. And you have created a solution, Lindsay, with BlueDot Global that's designed as a global early warning system. So how do you predict that nightmare scenario with BlueDot?
There's a few steps to understanding where diseases are happening and where they will occur. So the first is just, again, tracking what outbreaks are happening globally. And this is because what's happening on one side of the world could easily transmit to another side of the world in a matter of just a few hours over a plane. So first is, we need to be tracking outbreaks in near real time around the world, and that's a huge exercise in and of itself. The second is understanding where these outbreaks may end up. So with global air travel patterns, where are diseases susceptible to spread to? Finally, the third is understanding what contextual factors make a disease essentially turn into an outbreak. And so this means that you need to look at everything from, you know, global air travel data, but also population data, climate, mosquito data, demographic data, and as well as a country's ability to respond to an outbreak. So once you combine and layer all those data and those modeling techniques, you can really understand where disease will spread to and what the impact will be.
In 2016, you successfully predicted the Zika outbreak. Given that the frequency of these types of outbreaks is increasing and is going to continue to increase going forward, how can healthcare organizations and healthcare departments globally be ready for this?
One, they just need to have better global awareness of what might be coming into their hospital doors at any given moment. And as I've described, this is a big exercise in and of itself. Healthcare workers are not all trained in infectious diseases, right? So what we're expecting out of our frontline healthcare workforce is to manage these diseases that they've never seen before, they've never been trained on before, and maybe they've never even heard of before. So what we need to do is empower them with information and tools that allows them to better triage patients as soon as they come in that may be infectious and could pose a risk to them and to their patients and ultimately cause an outbreak. So with better data and information, we can really get ahead of these outbreaks.
Going back to the first point about tracking, that's got to be a very significant challenge. So what kind of technology have you created around that?
We use machine learning and natural language processing techniques to process over 10,000 articles a day in over 60 languages. This is just something that a human on their own cannot do. That is really the technology that we use to process that information on a daily basis and give that global situational awareness. At the moment, a lot of the processes in government agencies is doing that manually. And so what we're doing is we're automating that surveillance for them, and then we're contextualizing it and allowing them to understand what risks they may face and what diseases may enter their borders so that they can make better decisions.
A tremendous amount of value for people's general welfare in predicting what's going to come next. So where does the AI enter in actually getting to the point where you can predict the next outbreak so it can be completely averted?
I think that what we can do is we can use that technology to get us farther and farther and become faster and faster. I think at the end of the day, and why BlueDot is so unique, is that you need that unique combination of subject matter expertise under one roof to really understand these problems. And so I think it would be a little bit dangerous for this to be completely automated by artificial intelligence, but we can use that to be more efficient and to help us get quicker with these decisions.
This is such a gigantic global problem you're tackling. Where do you start with investors?
I think we've really established our credibility and our track record over the past few years. You know, we've been working with leading global agencies like the WHO, the US CDC, the Public Health Agency of Canada. And so we have really proven that we can predict the spread of these outbreaks. And now we're really ready to grow and to enter new markets. So to get into the healthcare industry, to get into travel, to get into insurance.
Healthcare costs ultimately can be significantly contained. If an outbreak can be detected early. Have you thought about or talked about what the returns to the health agencies could be? Because obviously taxpayers globally are going to be very interested in a solution that can lower healthcare costs overall.
It's really hard to quantify that. What we can do is we can quantify how much quicker we can be with that information. So on average, we are 43 days faster than official government reporting sources are reporting these outbreaks. And in healthcare, we're just getting started.